They've been brewing beer here at Fitger's in Duluth since 1881. Today it's a small operation called Fitger's Brewhouse, and two or three times a week the stainless steel tanks and pipes bubble and flow with cranes and liquids. Early in the process, the copper and wooden vats have to be emptied of the barley waste.
This is where the grain gets removed from the mash tun. And what's left of this grain has a lot of protein in it.
It's a rich-looking mash of golden barley that has served its purpose. And there's a lot of it.
There'll be 6 to 8 of these buckets per batch.
And that's twice a day?
Yes, twice a day.
6 or 8 150-pound buckets of leftovers is too good to waste. So this enterprising little company has come up with a novel new use for the spent grain. This barley has given up its starches and sugars, but it's still full of protein and fiber. So it's on its way to be reprocessed in a most unusual way. It will be back, but in an entirely different form. Every brew day, farmer Rob Strom collects the steaming tubs of cooked barley and hauls it to his property near Twig, Minnesota.
Let's go.
There, he's raising a dozen Highland cattle, an unusual breed that originated in Scotland. With their long, shaggy coats and fearsome horns,
come on.
These animals are well insured against the sub-zero winter temperatures and the wolves of northern Minnesota. And just like us, they obviously relish a hot meal on a cold day.
They know it's coming. They love it. Because they're initially all grass-fed and they're finished on the grain, so they didn't even know what to expect.
The cattle soon got the hang of it, and within a strict pecking order, they eat as much as Rob Strom will give them.
They eat the grain, and they're instantly thriving.
Thriving until one day not too far in the future, when this highly prized beef will be cut up and cooked at a new restaurant in Duluth called Tycoon's. A direct connection between the grower and the customer.
It seemed to make sense economically, but more as a way to make sure that we could control the quality and the taste of what was coming to the table.
Jason Davis, Eyewitness News on the road, Duluth.